Kerry Suter is a legend in the world of ultra marathons, a runner who twice won the 100-kilometre Tarawera Ultra, and a charismatic coach who taught thousands of others to dig deep when the going gets tough. But now Kerry faces his greatest ever physical and mental challenge. Can his willpower triumph over adversity? Tonight, Mark Criswell meets Kerry and partner Ali in love and on a journey they never expected.
Where the hell are my sideburns?
Once met...
Errol Jacks!
Get away!
Kerry Suter is hard to forget.
Are you meant to eat an onion?
Yeah.
Oh, can't we be friends?
Just ask Ali Pottinger.
I was on the dance floor and he was walking past and I don't know why, but I said to him, where are you going?
She asked me who I was and I said, I think you should know I'm a pretty big deal. She laughed and started making fun of me.
Kerry Suter is a champion ultra marathon runner and coach.
Distance was no obstacle. I had the strength of a bear that had the strength of two bears. I was unstoppable.
One of our great outdoor adventurers.
I've seen him at the end of a 25-hour adventure and he's been going, no sleep, and he's just in the zone.
I always wanted to be on top of those mountains looking down.
And for the past 7 years, Ali Pottinger's partner in life and the business of coaching people to run crazy long distances.
For what it's worth, we're going to do the legit 50K course.
For 44 years, Kerry Suter always landed on his feet, until he didn't.
I'm in ICU now, and I won't make it.
You will make it.
You always think, you know, that it's not going to happen to you, but you can break.
The first day of the rest of Kerry's new life dawned in February, sunny and warm.
It was an ordinary Saturday morning.
Just heading off into the forest for a ride.
Kerry is Rhys Johnston's coach.
Yeah, good, eh?
Took him from non-runner to twice winning the gut-busting Tarawera 100-kilometre ultramarathon.
Man, what do I owe Kerry? I'd do anything for that guy.
The weekend before, they'd climbed three mountains, Ruapehu, Tongariro and Ngauruhoe, in less than a day.
Rocks and scoria and, you know, bloody knees and bloody hands.
Here we are, top of Ngauruhoe, Kerry Suter.
Now they were blowing away the cobwebs on mountain bikes in Rotorua's Whakarewerewa forest.
I wanted to go and try a trail that was probably next level for me.
Oh, what a day.
But on the trail known as Jekyll and Hyde, Kerry misjudged a 2 metre drop.
Oh, God! Oh, oh. Ha, ha, ha.
Landed hard on the front wheel and went over the handlebars and hit square on my head.
You squeezed my hand, mate?
No.
He immediately knew he wasn't going to walk away from this one.
Just stay still, brother. Stay still, man. We got you.
I could feel nothing and I knew I was in trouble.
I feel like my legs are floating.
Rhys gently cradled his mate's head.
His body was lifeless. From his shoulders down, he initially could just, with his right hand, just squeeze my finger. I knew straight away what it's going to be for him. It's really hard.
What went through your mind, Kerry, when you were lying there?
Do you want to catch this? Grab this to you, please. Can you just quickly have a watch?
Oh, yeah.
Looks so too.
First responders were on their way, but Kerry needed to tell Ali.
What did you say to her?
I said it was a bad one, and I said, I'm going to hospital, that I can't feel my legs.
No, you said I can't feel anything. Yeah.
it was, like, impossible to understand, to be honest. Like,
I couldn't make sense of it. It was like I just totally blue screened. Like, when he said that, it just didn't compute.
Kerry's neck was badly dislocated. He was medevaced out of the forest.
What probably saved my life was the quick response of the first responders, Alec and Budgie and his team, who got me out of the forest and onto a helicopter.
Surgery stabilised him.
About 70 hours from surgery when I got here.
Yeah.
In Littlemore.
Yeah.
And today's update is my right arm now move a little bit.
That's more than a little bit, that's a lot.
But the stark reality is that Kerry is now a tetraplegic.
I can do very little other than just sort of raise a bicep up, and the most successful thing I can do with that is I can punch myself in the face.
No.
I can use that to scratch my nose or something.
The legs, which once charged up mountains, no longer do what they're told.
Really no sensation under about armpit level.
There is no cure for tetraplegia.
Very hard not to be pessimistic, to be honest, because every day you're dealt the same terrible hand. Every day you're in that hard part of the ultramarathon where you don't know if you're going to get to the finish line.
That finish line looks very different now.
It's way less movement than you think.
It's here at Auckland's Spinal Rehabilitation Unit that he's learning how to go back out into the big wide world.
What day is it, Kerry?
Arm day.
Wins these days are smaller, but still significant.
Is that? Well, wait, maybe. Yeah, okay. First use of the fork.
Yeah.
Nailed it.
Working out. Geeking out. And busting out.
What are we doing?
We're going on an adventure.
To the wilderness of...
We can't spend a whole time looking over our shoulder. The rainbow is actually always in front of us. So there's no point grieving for any longer than you need to. It's a natural process.
What are you grieving for?
My calf muscles.
Kerry's sweet body. Honestly, it's the little things, like, you know, walking along holding hands, like, I'd run and jump on him in the kitchen. I don't know, you have all these little things, like just day-to-day realisations that you go, oh, that's not going to happen like this anymore.
My Michael Jackson's dance moves.
Your sweet dance moves.
Yep.
But Kerry and Ellie still find ways to dance.
We're having an Easter raid.
They've always been a team, but Kerry knows he now needs Ellie more than ever.
Yeah, this is really hard because I realised that when I had the accident, you know, I kind of ruined her life too.
And it was something that I actually didn't want him to do either, so it's hard to not have the, you know, I told you so, but that the heartbreak for him and what it means for him now outweighs any kind of blame.
I'm incredibly lucky. She's, you know, loving, you know, she's caring, she's patient. You know, she's so kind, she has so much empathy. She's taught me so much in that regard, and I'm strong, but she's much stronger.
What do I love about Kerry? That's gonna make me cry. I think, well, the thing I love about him is just that he loves me. Yeah, being seen exactly as you are and loved is like just the most precious thing, yeah.
There will be potholes on the road ahead.
We're nearly there, it's only 800 metres to go.
But they're also picking up a passenger on the way.
They called and they went, congratulations, and I was kind of like laughing.
Yeah, so Ellie, how many weeks are you?
About 18 and a half.
After 6 years of IVF, Kerry and Ellie are having a baby.
Wow, that's waving. I would like a boy. I just think that would be really fun. Kerry's already got two girls. He thinks it's going to be a girl. I mean, either way, it'll be a beautiful thing.
I thought of mine this morning. I thought Sylvie's quite nice.
Sylvie?
And that means from the forest.
What about Jane? You know, just like a just Jane. Everyone knows how to spell it, right? J, A.
Soon Kerry will leave the spinal unit and head back home to Rotorua. The man who once ran up mountains now needs wheels to knock the buggers off.
I'm free.
But after 3 months in the spinal unit, just being outside is life-affirming.
You know, you realise that the sun feels great, you can feel the wind across your body, you know, you can still taste food. You know, this is living, you know, this is life.
The force of nature and the tenderness of nurture.
Okay, so baby names that are hill-related.
Hill-related?
Yeah, like Hilly.
They would have to be like Hillary.
Okay. Hillary.
I don't know if you could get away with that.
Eden.
Oh, Eden.
Hey, how about that? We've got a contender.
Life for Kerry now is about refinding purpose, wherever that may be.
When the injury is so bad that you're a head on a pillow and nothing moves, you wonder if life is worth living. Whether you'll find purpose, whether there's enough life left.
And what conclusion did you come to, Kerry?
I have kids. I have a beautiful partner. She's pregnant. Life's worth living.
I'm glad you came to that conclusion, mate.
Me too.
Yeah, it's taken enormous courage. Kerry and Ellie say they're determined to keep coaching runners when they get back home to Rotorua. Their goal is to be on the finish line, shouting them on at the end of next year's Tarawera Ultra Marathon.